drumbeats of the 2022 race to State House have been getting louder by day. And one man has been having a field day, Deputy President William Ruto, seemingly only rivaled by a veteran famous for surprise comebacks, former Prime Minister and ODM party leader Raila Odinga.
Sai, mimi ndio nimekaribia. Sasa wakiniunga mkono iko makosa? Sasa iko haja gani ya kuzungukana tena, simu nisaidie tu nifike haraka hivi.
Mimi ndio na wananchi. Mimi nimesema sijatangaza mimi nataka kusimama urais.
So just what would it take to dislodge Ruto and Odinga from the front row?
One nation.
Perhaps the most critical constitutional parameter to gauge the 2022 Kenyatta succession race is the mandatory 50% plus one vote threshold, also tied to the demand that a winning presidential candidate must garner at least 25% of votes in at least 24 of the 47 counties. A delicate threshold which analysts argue will push the pre-2022 political landscape into political horse trading to form coalitions to grant the candidates some semblance of national stature. Facing expulsion from his Jubilee party though, Ruto has coined what he calls the hustler movement, hoping to galvanize the lowest cadre society, who have historically proven to be the biggest percentage of voters. This is all of Odinga's 2017 coalition partners ANC's Musalia Mudavadi, Wiper's Kalonzo Musyoka and Ford Kenya's Moses Wetangula, gang up with President Uhuru Kenyatta's right-hand man and Jubilee coalition partner, KANU National Chairman Gideon Moi, under the One Kenya Alliance, with the name of fielding one presidential candidate in 2022.
The only person that can take over from President Uhuru and make this country move forward is Raila Amolo Odinga. Any dreams, any illusions that he will support anybody, if that is in somebody's mind, let him or her wake up, because that is not going to happen.
Musalia has presented himself as a safe pair of hands before. He has also presented himself as a person who understands what this economy needs, and he can do something about the economics. Now, if he can do that, and if he can convince the capital owners and the elites, the middle class, that he is a safer pair, with the support of Raila, he does stand a chance.
Observers say that the prevailing pre-2022 political stalemate somewhat mirrors the 1992 presidential contest, where retired president, the late Daniel Arap Moi, squared it against several formidable opposition candidates, including the late Kenneth Matiba of Ford Asili, DP's Mwai Kibaki and the late Jaramogi Oginga Odinga of Ford Kenya. Moi eventually won with a shallow margin of 36%. Against what would have been a combined opposition vote of 62%. Analysts argue that should the prevailing formations hold until 2022, a presidential runoff will be inevitable.
If we can get a presidential candidate that can marshal numbers and avoid a rerun, a presidential rerun, so much the better. Because a presidential rerun ostensibly will balkanize this country, and it's something that we should avoid if we can.
Whoever may come up will not necessarily be part of a gang. Be someone who just comes up and forcefully places himself in the public mind as the right person.
It will also come to us, what are you also bringing on the table? In terms of numbers and in terms of even resources, because that will also inform who will be the flag bearer.
The unfortunate thing in this country is you are either having Raila or having Ruto. If Ruto were to join you the way he joined Raila, he gives you certain impetus that then politically gives you mileage. If Raila is to join you the way he joined Kibaki, he gives you impetus and gives you mileage.
The Court of Appeal is due to rule on the Building Bridges Initiative referendum push, seen as the state's most critical 2022 succession master plan. And with some 12 months to go to the 2022 finish line, More realignments beckon as President Kenyatta edges closer to his exit. Murimi Mwangi, KTN News.